Hi guys, this is Rio from Japan. In this video, I'm going to explain the anatomy of rotator cuff. I'm showing you a model of scapula and humerus, shoulder joint. This red tape represents each rotator cuff muscle. So there are four muscles of rotator cuff. I'm going to explain each one. So first one is on top of your shoulder. On top of your scapula, this muscle is supraspinatus. Supraspinatus originates from this concave surface. This concave surface is supraspinous fossa. Name of muscle is supraspinatus. This place is supraspinous fossa. It is kind of easy to remember if you remember the one terminology. So, its insertion is here. This place is greater tubercle. Greater tubercle. And the main function of supraspinatus is when you raise up your shoulder this way, this motion is called abduction. Abduction. So this is abduction. Supraspinatus from supraspinous fossa. It inserts here, greater tubercle. Its main function is abduction. So let's move on to next one. The next one is this red tape, this muscle. This muscle is infraspinatus. I just explained supraspinatus. Supra means up, and this muscle, infraspinatus. Infra means down. So infraspinatus is much broader muscle. It's much bigger than this red tape. I'm just using this red tape as simplifying the muscle anatomy. So infraspinatus originates from this whole surface. This place is called infraspinous fossa. Again, what was the origin of supraspinatus? Supraspinous fossa. Infraspinatus originates from infraspinous fossa. It is easy if you remember one structure, one terminology, you can remember the other one. Simple enough, right? And this infraspinatus function is shoulder external rotation. External rotation is you twist arm this way, outside, outward. So on this model, if infraspinatus contracts, it brings shoulder this way. It twists arm this way. This is external rotation. Infraspinatus, external rotation. And if you see this muscle is different. This muscle is called teres minor. Teres minor is from a lateral border of scapula. You know, this is lateral side and this is medial side. So teres minor originates from lateral border of scapula and attaches here, greater tubercle. By the way, infraspinatus, I just explained, infraspinatus attaches on greater tubercle as well. So supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and teres minor, these three muscles attach on greater tubercle. Teres minor from lateral border of scapula and greater tubercle. And its function is also external rotation. If you see the direction of the muscle from lateral border of scapula and greater tubercle. So if muscle contracts, it pulls this way. That's why this muscle does external rotation. The last one is from anterior side. You are watching this model from anterior side. This muscle is subscapularis. You know, subscapularis is much broader than this tape representation. I'm just giving this as simple as possible. Subscapularis from this surface. This surface is called subscapular fossa. Again, subscapularis, subscapular fossa. Easy to remember. Subscapularis originates from subscapular fossa and attaches on here. This is different from the other three muscles. This place is called lesser tubercle. Other three attach on greater tubercle, but subscapularis attaches on lesser tubercle. This is different. And main function of subscapularis is internal rotation. Internal rotation. Why? Because we observe the orientation of muscle, it's from anterior side of scapula and attaches on anterior side of humerus. So if muscle pulls shoulder this way, this makes internal rotation. Internal rotation. So two muscles do external rotation, which is infraspinatus and teres minor. And superspinatus does abduction, raise shoulder this way. And subscapularis is internal rotation. So remembering rotator cuff is a little bit hard to do, especially you are just beginner of anatomy or you are just taking anatomy class. But if you remember the muscle in three-dimensional orientation, or you can borrow the bony model from classroom and you put tape on it, and so you remember it. You kind of observe the textbook and you put the tape. So it is a process of learning. So I hope this video helps remembering rotator cuff. So this is today's video. If you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.